every day at school, painting all the time. It's very funny, running in the park. And when you are at home, something's not fine. You're really dirty,
and your feet smell bad.
What is it? I wonder who it could be. Can any of you help me? Who is that singing?
It's Pato!
Pato! So it was you. I had no idea you could sing like that. There you are. There's nothing Pato loves more than getting clean. How many showers is that today for you, Pato? Three? Oh, I'm sorry. Four, of course. You'd better get going, though. Pocoyo and Elly are waiting for you. Yes, indeed. Being clean certainly makes Pato happy. Pato! Pato! Look out for that! Phew! That was a close one. I think Elly and Pocoyo are having lunch. I wonder what they're having. Don't you want a sandwich, Pato? Oh, I see. Too messy, is it? Pato, why don't you come out now? I'm sure Pocoyo and Elly have finished eating now. Yes, they're bound to be playing something else by now. Now, where can they be? Finger painting, getting messy and having fun. Oh, dear. Yes. It's all right, you two. It's just that I don't think poor Pato wants to finger paint either. You see, he just took a shower. What is it, Elly? 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 Pocoyo? You know, Pato, you needn't be so worried about getting dirty. Yes, I know you're clean, but Pocoyo and Elly have finished painting. I wonder what they're playing now. It can't be anything as messy as painting, can it?
Muppie!
dear. Well, that was amazing, Pato. Not a spot of mud on you. Uh-oh. Wait a minute. Well, Pato was trying so hard to keep clean, but can any of you tell him what's happened?
He's dirty!
Ugh.
Yes, I'm afraid to say, Pato, you've got a spot of mud on you. Look. Pato? 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 You know, I was trying to tell you before, getting dirty isn't such a bad thing. No, no, it's true. Think of it this way. You like getting clean, don't you? Well, how much fun would it be to get clean if you didn't get just a little bit dirty first? Oh, look, how nice. Your friends even brought you a bathtub. I suppose Pato worked out that if getting a little dirty makes bath time a little more fun, then getting a lot dirty will make it a lot more fun. Hooray for getting dirty and for getting clean. Hooray for Pato. Hooray for Pocoyo. See you in the tub later. Bye-bye.
With Elly? Oh, Elly is having a bath with a rubber duck. Hello, Elly. Can you tell Pocoyo what Elly is doing? Right. She's having a bath. You'll have to wait, Pocoyo. Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. What are you reading?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, there was a dinosaur riding a bicycle. He was so happy. But it started to rain, and he got wet. The dinosaur didn't like being wet. So his friend the ant helped him dry off. He liked it so much that he got wet again. So the ant helped him dry again. The dinosaur loved getting dry. So he got wet again. Then dry. Wet. Dry. Really, really, really wet. And dry. The end. Elly is taking a long time in the bath. I wonder what she's doing. She's playing with a bubble. That's a lovely bubble, Elly. Can you tell Pocoyo what Elly is playing with in the bath?
A bubble!
She's playing with a bubble.
Can you tell Pocoyo who is having a bath now?
The rubber duck!
The rubber duck!
Animals, dot to dot. Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
Penguin! It's a penguin!
Yes! It's a penguin!
Penguin!
Well done! Last, Elly is ready to play. Get it, Elly! Oh my! I wonder what Pocoyo is doing. Having a bath? You're right, Elly. Playing in the bath is fun.
Bye.
watering his plants with flowers. Now he's all grubby. After gardening for hours, he takes off his hat. When he gets home, ready for a bath, make sure there's lots of foam. Pato loves his bathtub. Pato's getting cleaned up. He loves the water. When it's warm and bubbly, now he's ready. And the sponge is soapy, he scrubs with a brush. It's the best thing. When he's in the bath, he feels just like a king. Pato loves his bathtub. Pato's getting cleaned up. Now he's dreaming, sailing on the sea. Such a wonderful feeling. A captain is he. When he's in the water, Pato likes to stay a little longer to splash around and play. Pato loves his bathtub. Pato's getting cleaned up. After an hour, it's time to leave the water wrapped in a towel.
He's feeling warmer.
After his dinner, Pato puts on his pajamas. Then he's off to bed to dream of the Bahamas. Pato loves his bathtub. It feels so good to get cleaned up. Pato loves his bathtub. It feels so good to get cleaned up. Pato loves his bathtub. It feels so good to get cleaned up.
Hello, Loula. Oh dear, you're getting very dirty. You know what happens when you get dirty, don't you? That's right. It's time for a bath. Come on, get in the bathtub, Loula. Oh no! Loula, come back! It's just a bath. It won't hurt you. Ah, Elly, thank you. What's that, Pocoyo?
Soap.
Soap, wonderful. And what's that, Elly? A brush. Great! Very soon, Loula will be nice and clean.
Surfing the net with Elly.
Hi, Elly. Pocoyo wants you to search for a word on your computer.
Clean.
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 Pocoyo wants to see something clean. Ah, it's Fred. Oh my. Are Fred's teeth clean?
No, they're dirty.
Clean, 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 clean. Clean.
I think we'd all like to see Fred clean those teeth. Ah, much better. It feels great to have clean teeth.
Thank you, Elly.
Yes, thank you, Elly. Well done. There. Loula is nice and clean. Uh-oh. Oh, dear. Here we go again. Can you tell Pocoyo what Elly wants?
The soap,
the brush,
the soap and the brush.
Soap, brush.
Shape shuffle. A square.
Square.
A circle.
Circle.
A rectangle.
Rectangle.
Square, circle, rectangle. Ooh, what's this, Pocoyo?
MP3.
An MP3 music player. And you've made it with circles, squares, and rectangles. Oh, a speaker. Can you tell me the names of the shapes?
Rectangles.
And these?
Squares.
And these?
Circles.
Square, circle, rectangle. Now Loula is really clean. Doesn't that feel nice, Loula? Uh-oh. This doesn't look good. Ah, good work. But it looks like someone else is dirty now. Yes, you, Pocoyo. Pocoyo, it's just a bath. It won't hurt you.
Toothbrush
is what you need.
Toothpaste
is all you need.
After dinner, before sleep, don't forget to brush your teeth. Now your teeth are really clean, and you're ready for sweet dreams.
Oh, look, it's Pato. Hello, Pato. What have you got there? Soap, a brush, and a towel. What are you going to do with that? Oh, you're going to have a shower? Lovely. Oh, dear. What's this? Pato's soap, brush, and towel are gone. How is he going to have a shower now? A quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Shower cap?
Shower cap!
A doll? Oh.
Doll!
A phone.
Phone. Bye.
Phone!
Oh dear. Good night. Does anyone see Pato's soap?
There it is!
There's the soap!
Good job! You found it! Does anyone see Pato's brush?
Elly has it!
She has the brush!
What is that on the scooter?
It's the towel! The towel!
The towel!
Oh dear, Pato is really angry that you took his things. And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, skip. That's it, skip. Fred says, clap hands. Come on, let's clap. That's it, clap. Fred says, spin! Spin! Well done! Fred says, that's all! Oh, no. Pato's brush and soap. Pato, your soap is, right here. Pato's ready for his brush. And ready for his towel. Hooray for showers! And hooray for towels!
I take a shower, wearing my shower cap. I use the soap and then the brush. I take a shower, wearing my shower cap. I use the soap and then the brush. And when I finish, I use the towel. And when I finish, then the phone rings.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
What shall we play today, Pocoyo? Yes, I see it too, Pocoyo. Something shiny. I'm not sure Pocoyo knows what that is. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what this is? Exactly, a key. And who knows what surprises it might unlock. How exciting. Yes, and you know, if I didn't know better, I'd say that was the kind of key they once used to open old pirates' treasure chests.
Treasure? Treasure! Treasure!
That's amazing. It looks like... It is a keyhole, Pocoyo.
Treasure?
Give it a try. Well, I don't know about treasure, but I've never seen anything like that before.
Hello. Treasure. Treasure. Treasure.
Well, there's no treasure here. Sorry for waking you, sleepy bird.
Key. Treasure. Treasure! Key! Treasure! Treasure! Treasure!
Hey! Another keyhole! I didn't realize we had a basement.
Treasure! Treasure.
Surprised to see us, Pato?
Fisher Pato. Yay!
Wow, a lift! How exciting! Go on, give it a try. Now they're on the bottom of the sea. Well, this looks like it's as far as you can go, doesn't it? I don't believe it. Look!
Treasure!
You know, I think it just might be. Nothing would surprise me after what I've seen today. Go ahead, Pocoyo. Open it. I wonder what's inside. Sweets? Toys? What could the treasure be? What is it? What's there? Will all of you go and look and tell me what's in the treasure chest?
It's lots of keys!
Treasure!
This is the best treasure of all, isn't it? After the fun we've had today. Keep opening doors, asking questions, and exploring your world. That is the key to it all. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi,
Elly. Hola, Pato. What's that sound? Oh, I see. Pato has set his alarm. That's odd. Packing? Where are you off to, Pato? You're going to visit your friends, Fred and Whale, underwater. What fun! Good idea. You'll need those where you're going. You're wondering what Pato is up to, right? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Elly where Pato is going?
To visit Whale and Octopus.
He's going underwater.
Bye, Pato. Have fun. Playing with friends underwater. What could be more fun? What's this? A ball! Great! You're going to play catch! Oh! It's hard to play catch underwater. All of your toys are floating away. What are you going to play with? Ah, your trumpet. Now this should be fun. Oh dear. Apparently, trumpets and water don't mix. now here's something you can enjoy. A comic book. Oh dear, it's ruined. Pato? Dear, being underwater even puts a damper on your tantrum. I'm afraid Pato isn't having as much fun as he expected to. Ah, nothing like a nice meal to cheer you up, right, Pato? Woohoo! That certainly is an interesting dish. Seaweed spaghetti, is it? Pato wants to know if you'd like to eat some. No, me? No. Oh, no, no, no. I ate earlier. I think you'll have to tuck in, Pato. Good work, Pato. Oh, dear, you're not leaving, are you, Pato? Is it because none of your toys worked? And you don't like the food here? I suppose you're missing home. Looks like Whale is going to give you a ride before you leave, just to show you how much fun being underwater can be. Wow! Whee! This is kind of fun, isn't it? There's something else Whale would like to show you before you go, Pato. A bubble. Look at that. You can play ball in there, just like at home. This? Sponges. A sponge trampoline. What fun! It looks as if Pato is having a really great time. What do you think? Does Pato like it underwater after all? This? A giant shell? What's inside?
Yeah.
It's Pocoyo and Elly! Hooray for getting used to new things! And hooray for fishy friends! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Muckstruck. Hello, Elly. Making a nice cup of tea? Oh, dear. That won't do. Good morning, Pocoyo. Ah, bath time. Aren't you forgetting something? Your water's gone bad too. Hello, Pato. Oh, do be careful. Your water has a rather icky colour too. Pato? Something must be done about this nasty water straight away. Very good. You should follow the water pipe to the start. The water in this pond simply must be cleaned up. That poor fish. Oh, we should help him. Very good, Pocoyo. You certainly are collecting lots of rubbish. Wonderful, Pato. This pond will be clean in no time. Everyone. But I'm afraid the water is still brown. Done, every one of you. Well done indeed. Ah, what a perfect morning on the nice clean pond. And it's all thanks to all your hard work, guys.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Did you see that?
Do you know what that was? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what that is?
It's an old tire!
That's right! It's an old tire someone has thrown away. What's this? A broken alarm clock. What are you going to do with that? Oh, I see. You're throwing it away. Well, why not?
More!
More? Seems as if Sleepy Bird has some rubbish to get rid of as well. Well, looks like everyone is getting in on the act. Cleaning up can be fun. And it's certainly a nice feeling to be rid of all that junk. What's this? Caterpillar. Oh dear, I'm afraid that your doorstep has got a little messy. Pato, you've just pushed the rubbish into the sea. Eggs smell good, do they, Fred? I know, Fred. No one likes rubbish in their eggs. How will you ever get rid of all that junk? Goodness! More rubbish! I agree, Pocoyo. I certainly don't like it when rubbish falls from the sky onto my blocks. Would any of you like to have a pile of rubbish land in your play area?
No!
What are you doing, Pocoyo? Oh, I see. You've decided to follow the rubbish to find out where it goes. Good plan. It's going in a circle. Because everyone keeps throwing it onto someone else. Throwing the rubbish around doesn't seem to help, does it? But what can we do?
Stop!
I think Pocoyo has found a way to solve the problem. Solution. Instead of simply throwing the rubbish away, you've worked out how to put it to good use. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for teamwork! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Nina. Hello, Pato. What a lovely day to care for your plants. Oh dear. Pato, it seems someone shut the water off. What was that? Pato. Pato, please slow down a bit. You say you saw a little green creature like this one? Her name is Nina. Why not introduce yourself, Pocoyo?
Pocoyo.
And this is Roberto. Hello, Nina and Roberto. It seems she's never shaken hands before.
Up.
umbrella. But it's not raining. So, you've seen Pato before. You were playing with your friend the ladybug, and Pato came. He watered the plant, and you got all wet. Oh, but Nina, I'm quite sure Pato didn't mean to get you wet. Pato was just watering his plants to help them grow. Yes, because he loves plants more than almost anything. She says that anyone who loves plants deserves a hug. Oh, I see. That's to warn Nina whenever Pato waters the plants. Brilliant! This calls for a celebration. Roberto, would you?
Hey, there's Loula. Hello, Loula. Oh, I wonder what she's looking at. She's very excited, isn't she? Oh, look, a bubble. That's what Loula was waiting for. Careful, Loula, you might burst it. Dear, bubbles are really easy to burst, Loula. It's above you, Loula. Quick! You know, where there are bubbles, there has to be someone making bubbles. Do any of you know who's making those bubbles?
Pocoyo!
Oh, yes. Look, it's Pocoyo. And Elly, too. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Elly.
Hi.
So it was you making the bubbles.
Bubbles.
Can you show us how, Pocoyo? Right. So you put the wand into the bubble juice, then blow it to make the bubbles. That's great!
Bubbles!
Elly wants a go at making bubbles now. Oh, aren't bubbles fabulous? Done, Elly.
Bubbles!
Ha-ha! Look at that! Oh, now, just a minute, you two. Oh, dear. But we were all having such fun. Look at poor Loula. She still wants to play with bubbles. Oh, can't you make some bubbles for Loula, Pocoyo?
No bubbles.
Well, what about you, Elly? Just one bubble for Loula. I think Loula misses the bubbles. It's too bad there aren't any more bubbles, isn't it? It's no use. Pocoyo can't make Loula any bubbles. And neither can Elly. Now, let's see. Pocoyo can't make bubbles without the bubble juice. And Elly can't make bubbles without the wand. Can any of you help Pocoyo and Elly work out how to make more bubbles?
Share.
Now that's a great idea. Now that's more like it.
Bubbles.
Good for you, Pocoyo and Elly. You're sharing and making bubbles for Loula together. It seems it's even more fun to play with friends when you share. Just ask Loula. Hooray for Pocoyo and for Elly and for Loula. Bye. See you soon. It's a beautiful, sunny day where our friend Pocoyo lives. Oh, hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Do you know what that is? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what it is? Yes, that's an umbrella, Pocoyo.
Umbrella!
Very good. An umbrella is for... Oh, I see. Pocoyo wants to find out for himself. Good for you, Pocoyo. All right. Now then, it's a beautiful, sunny... if somewhat windy day. Oh, look! It's Loula! Opens and closes. Very good. Whoops. Pocoyo. Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Oh, now how are you ever going to get down from there? Oh, I see. As I was saying, it's a beautiful, if sometimes quite windy, day. Oh, yes, Pocoyo, perhaps you should take a better look. What could an umbrella be used for? Do you hear someone quacking? Oh, yes, Pocoyo, very good. What? Oh, you think the umbrella moved? Are you sure? It's all right, Pato. You can come out. Hello, Elly. Maybe Elly knows what an umbrella is for. I wonder where Elly is going. Oh, Elly, what a wonderful way to use an umbrella. But I'm afraid we may need it for something else, and soon. I think Pocoyo and his friends are about to get wet, unless... Pocoyo, can you think of anything that might keep you dry? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what will keep him dry?
The umbrella!
Umbrella!
That's right, Pocoyo. Umbrellas keep you dry. Hooray for Pocoyo! Well, as I was saying, it's all in all a breezy, windy, cloudy, rainy, sunny, beautiful day for Pocoyo and his friends. And thanks to you and Pocoyo, it's also nice and dry. Bye now. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Pocoyo is going to have lots of fun today. He's off to play with his friend Pato. What's this? I think it's a shadow. Yes, that shadow seems to be following you, Pocoyo. What could be making the shadow? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what's making the shadow? Yes, it's a little cloud. I wonder where he came from.
Hmm.
there's Pato. Perhaps he can help.
Yes, well, not so funny now, is it, Pato? Oh, Pato doesn't like the cloud either. The little cloud is crying.
Cloud cries?
How strange. If I didn't know better, I'd think, yes, it's true. The cloud's feelings are hurt. I wonder, what will you do now, Pocoyo? You've got an idea. What is it? Oh, I see. You want to talk to the cloud. That's a wonderful idea, Pocoyo, but I'm not sure the cloud can hear you.
Shout!
Terrific idea, Pocoyo. If you all shout together, the little cloud will be able to hear you.
Cloud!
Cloud!
Yes, it worked! I think the little cloud likes you, Pocoyo. I think perhaps, could it be? Yes, I think this little cloud just wants a friend.
Friend.
Pocoyo, cloud. Friends?
Friends.
I think the cloud would like to give his two new friends a ride. That means you too, Pato. What fun! There's Loula. And there's Elly. Look, Elly. Pocoyo and Pato have made a friend. Just as I always say, nothing brightens up your day like making a new friend. Hooray for Pocoyo! See you soon! Hello, Pocoyo. What are you doing? Oh, of course, we'll wait. Made a card, and a very nice one too. Do any of you know what it's a picture of?
A whale!
is that card for Whale? Wait, is it Whale's birthday today? Is Whale having a birthday party? Elly, are you taking a gift to Whale's birthday party? A balloon? But how do you wrap it up? Great work, Pocoyo! I wonder if Whale will be able to guess what it is.
Pato!
Let's see what Pato is making for Whale. What a wonderful cupcake, Pato! Well, Whale is going to love her gifts.
To Whale!
Oh dear, that sounded like a balloon popping. Oh dear. Well, at least we still have the card and the cupcake. What a lovely fish. Pato, I think you've lost something. Your cake. Something tells me that fish gobbled it. At least you still have Pocoyo's wonderful card. Yes, there's Whale.
Happy birthday, Whale!
It's been quite a trip, Whale. And everyone made lovely gifts for you. Elly was going to give you a wonderful balloon. But unfortunately, it popped along the way. And Pato made you a beautiful cupcake. But unfortunately, a little fish ate it up. Luckily, there's still another gift. Pocoyo made you a wonderful birthday card. Oh no! The water spoiled the lovely card Pocoyo made. Oh dear! No balloon, no cake, and no card. Look, Whale is happy, even if you haven't brought a card or a cake or a balloon. Can any of you tell Pocoyo, Pato and Elly what, or rather, who, they have brought to Whale's party?
They brought themselves!
Yes! Pocoyo, Pato and Elly are here! Hooray for the best gift of all! Friends! And hooray for Pocoyo! See you soon! Bye-bye!
Bye-bye!
Hello, Pocoyo!
Hello!
A box.
Box.
Yes, a box. What a wonderful thing a box is. Why, there's so much you can do with it. So many things a box can be. Pocoyo is playing pretend with the box. What are you pretending it is, Pocoyo?
Beep beep.
Can any of you tell? What is Pocoyo pretending the box is?
It's a car.
He's pretending it's a car.
Yes, a car.
Box car.
Pocoyo, look!
Box car! Dum, dum, dum.
Look at that! Your box car is moving all on its own, like a real car. Looks like Elly has a good idea for what the box could be. It's a table. But an unusual sort of table. The box is off again! And it looks like Pato has another idea for what the box could be. He's going to step on the box to reach that lovely juicy apple.
No!
Oops! Yes. Well, I'm afraid this box isn't like most boxes. Do you know why the box keeps running away? Let me give you a clue. There's something inside the box. It is very, very friendly, with floppy ears and a very waggy tail. Can you guess what it is? What about all of you? Can any of you tell our friends what or who is inside the box and making it move?
Loula!
That's right! It's Loula!
Loula?
Loula was in the box all the time. You know, I think Loula really likes that box. I wonder if there isn't something you could do with the box so that she could spend more time in it. Well, I suppose it just goes to show a box can be many things to many people. And to many dogs, too, for that matter. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for boxes! And hooray for you too, Loula! Bye-bye! See you soon!